All right, let's stand. Let's pray for the preacher this morning, pray for the singers. Pray that God will just bless them. I know we got a lot of people. Some of our people are gone to be with their moms. So it kind of gives you a mixed crowd, but I'm glad you're here with your mom. If your mom's not here, guess what? Someday we'll go visit. And just remember, this world's not our home. We're just a passing through. I'm glad my treasures. You ever think about them treasures? Them treasures, sometimes people talk about the gold and the silver and all that. That's not what I call treasure. I think those things that, you know, that I had here, that I count treasures. My mom and dad will be over there. My family will be there. And I believe that they're my treasures over there. So let's go to the Lord. Pray for the preaching and singing. Pray for those that's lost. We come on Mother's Day. We don't realize what's going to happen. Mom could be gone. I tell you what, if you don't have a hope, you're not going to see mom. Heavenly Father, we come to you. We thank you, Lord, for this service, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for the time that we have, Lord, with one another. We thank you, Lord, for the day, Lord, that you gave us, Lord, the strength, Lord, and saved us, Lord. Give us rich life, Lord, knowing you. Father, I thank you, Lord, for it, Lord. Feel, Lord, so unworthy, Lord, this morning. But, Lord, I'm so glad that you purchased the church. Lord, what a great, Lord, thing that it is to be part of the church, the living. Lord, we ask you, Lord, to touch, Lord. Father, Brother Bill, Lord, today, and Sister Doris, I know they're going through a great deal at family. But, God, I thank you, Lord, that your power lies, Lord, within your hand. And, Father, you're able to touch those. We ask you, Lord, to strengthen, Lord, this morning. Give us, Lord, what we need to this morning through the preaching. Lord, so good, Lord, to have Brother Dan with us. Lord, we ask you, Lord, just to touch his lips of clay, Lord. And we ask you, Lord, not only, Lord, to touch, Lord, him, but touch those that he preaches to, Lord, that your voice will ring in their hearts, Lord. We ask you, Lord, to touch the singers, Lord, anoint their voice, Lord. Lord, just give us a good time today. Lord, thank you for the visitors, Lord. We just appreciate that so much, Lord. We give you the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Choir, come. Let's get the same start. Sing the choir, we need your help. Thank you. on me when I started preaching, said, "Preacher, you're going to quit. You ain't going to keep that up." I said, "Oh, you don't even know what's in my heart. There's a fire there that keeps me going. I'm glad of that. I'm glad the fire, it might have flickered every once in a while, but it's never went out. Praise the Lord. I just praise Him for that. God is still the same today as He was yesterday. And I like that last part, if He changeth not. I'm glad He don't change. Somebody, amen.
Amen.
Amen. All right, ushers, come. Let's get their money. They're all in here locked in door. Shaking in front of Miss Mother's Day. Get to the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. Appreciate the time of giving. And guarantee you will be used to upbuild the kingdom of God. Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning. We appreciate the time that we do have, Lord, to worship you and giving. And Father, I pray, Lord, that you take all that we get this morning from your people, Lord, and use it wisely, Lord. And Father, as we begin to further the ministry with what they give us, Lord, we ask you, Lord, to multiply, Lord, where we can, Lord, do what we need to do. Father, we give you praise. Amen. Sunday.
Amen.
Well, that didn't go over real good, but it went over. I think some of you already made your mind that you wasn't gonna make it. All right, we're glad, but we do apologize, that was my slip up, because we had a change in a superintendent, and that's usually a superintendent job for Sunday school, and I messed up. I've been an acting superintendent for the last few months, but I apologize for that. Sister Annette, boy, did she do a good job on that, just hold her up in prayer, and then we're gonna let the preacher preach this morning. Now, I said that one time in a meeting, we're gonna let the preacher preach, and the preacher corrected me, and he said, "You had never let me preach." And I said, "Just get up there and try it without me." And he looked at me, and I said, "Get up there and try it without the people." I said, "You'll find out who's letting you." And he just looked at me, and I said, "What I'm saying, we can get up here and struggle and preach. I preach, my dad's heard me preach, just me. It ain't very good. But when God shows up, and God's people get up under him, whoo, there's a difference in it, man, there's a difference." So, you say it's not up to us. The Bible said, when that man was on the rooftop, letting him in, he said, "Seeing their faith, this man was made whole." We've got everything to do with it, folks. We got to come in one mind and one accord. It'll happen. Man, we know how to get up under the preacher here at the Faith Chapel. It's good. Come on, sis. We'll get up under you, too.
Psalm says broken ones.
Yeah.
You know, a mother's love, it's like a she bear. Try to take care of our kids, but I tell you, look, God's love is so much more of it.
Amen.
I think we're just little vessels that you can use to fill out his love, but his love is amazing. Goes beyond the depths of everything. Maggie came home one day with a raggedy arm. She said, "Mama, look what I found in the neighbor's garbage can. Had a missing left arm and a right eye hanging by a thread. She carried it gently up to her room and laid it on her bed with her other dolls. She loves the broken ones, the ones her needles and all patching up. She sees the diamond in the rough and makes it shine.
A willing heart and a tender touch. If everybody loves.
universe hung on a tree. Spear wound in his side, barely able to breathe. Tears flowed down his face as he cried, "Father, forgive me, please." And he died for me. And the broken ones, the ones in need of it all, patching up. He sees the diamond in the rough and makes it shine.
Some kind of an influence or an impression on your life. And the thing that makes you a mother today, being a special day as it is, are the children. If you didn't have children, it's hard to be a mother. Somehow, God brought all this together. And he brought it to you in a way that only comes as an individual. I'd like to read to you just a little bit out of the book of John this morning, or St. John. It's about what the sister was singing about, the last little bit about Christ being on the cross. Some of the last words that he spoke. Now you pray for me, because I'm about as weak as you get when it comes to preaching, because it belongs to God. I don't have the strength in me to do it. Don't have the wisdom or the knowledge. And it's all up to him. So I'd like for you to listen. We'll try to be brief in this. But in the 19th chapter, the book of St. John, in the 25th verse, it said, "There stood by the cross of Jesus, his mother, and his mother's sister Mary, the wife of Cleopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciple standing by, whom he loved, he saith unto his mother, Woman, behold thy son. Then saith he to the disciple, Behold thy mother. And from that hour, that disciple took her unto his own home." Now, that, I want you just to focus on this. Of all the people that have ever been born in this world, you can go ahead and be seated. Of all the people that have ever been born on this earth, the greatest man, and he was a God man, Brother Bruce, that came from God.
Amen.
He was conceived in this little woman by the Holy Ghost.
Come on, son.
Bless you all.
And I want you to begin to think with me just a little bit about how important she must have been to Jesus.
Yes, bless you all.
Come on, son.
Now you think that you might not be important this morning.
Come on.
But I want you to know you're important. Even though you may have lost your husband, even though that you bore the shame of a child out of wedlock, even though you bore all the problems. She didn't have anything. She was about 13 years old from what I can understand, Brother Herm. And she was overcome by the Holy Spirit. And the angel told her, said, now, look, you're going to conceive. And she said, how can I? How can I conceive? Because I'm a virgin. I've never known a man.
Yeah, bless you, Lord.
Now, you listen. What you might think is impossible, God's still got control.
Amen.
You look at this world. It's getting worse all the time.
Yeah, bless you, Lord.
Knowledge has increased beyond measure. But I want you to understand there is no new thing under heaven. That may be a big pill to swallow this morning with all the technology that man's got. He said there's no new thing.
Yeah, that's
now, let's look at this. What really is important today? Everybody got this thing covered up. The world has dumbed down society.
Come on.
They have dumbed us down to the point where, oh, we can water down the Word of God, we can water down the worship service, we can water down all the commandments, we'll take them out and throw them away. And let me tell you today, God is still God regardless of what goes on in the world. You cannot tear down what God has established.
Yeah.
Our God is still God.
Hey.
It doesn't matter today what the president has to say.
Yeah.
And what the leaders have to say.
Yeah.
Jesus on the cross. He looks down. There's Mom. I'm all she's got, her.
Yeah.
Ain't nobody else to help Mom but me. My brothers and sisters, they don't believe in what's going on here. They're not around.
Come on, yeah. Come on.
Nobody but Jesus can care for.
Yeah.
He looks down. He said, John, behold your mother.
Yeah.
Yeah, behold your mother. Look around you today. There may be a mother here that needs you today. Look around. Behold your mother. The charge is today. Oh, you say, preacher, we can't take care of everybody. No, listen, God was only commanded to take care of one.
Yeah.
Just one, Brother Herman.
Yeah.
I know that. That may not really work real good sometimes because Mom may be a little bit of a problem.
Yeah.
Yeah, Mom might be a little bit hard to deal with at times.
Come on, preacher, man.
Yeah.
She might think things are a little bit different than what they are. She might think it's prayer time. You might think it's play time.
Come on.
She might think it's time for a devotion. You might think, well, it's time to go to bed. I want you to understand something. The very importance of what this world needs is being passed by. Being passed right on by. Yeah, now you just bear with me just a minute. Sister was singing about that little girl. All the events of her life. Then we'll get back to Mary in just a minute. But I want you to know, there's somebody that really cares. There's somebody out there. Whether you know about it or not, there's somebody out there that cares. I was coming up the road this morning, speed going as it is, then the bird come out, hit the front of the car. I said, oh, I didn't mean to do that. Somebody wrote it down in here.
Come on.
He takes note even when the sparrows fall.
Yeah.
Yeah, Lord, you got it. Thank you.
You think you're unimportant? Listen to me. When that little sparrow hit the
concerning all these things. She's not contrary about it. She said, Lord, here's your handmaid. Whatever you need, I will. 13 years old. Brother Herman, you just look at the children today that are 13. They're not prepared for anything like that. How in the world did Mary get prepared for a job like raising Jesus? You think about that today, Mother. How important a mother's job really is. Oh, you say, well, I feed them and I see that they're bathed and I get them out of here. They got clothes on, but I can't control what else goes on. Honey, let me tell you today, Mary took care of Jesus. Could you imagine being 14 years old? My, the heavenly host singing around about you, about a child that had just been born. And let me tell you, God is still in the land.
Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord.
Mary, sitting there wondering, the world has happened. She's still pondering. Here is the angel, and here's the lady. You say, preacher, how important could it have been? I want you to understand something. Abraham Lincoln said that his mother was like an angel. Called her an angel mother. There was an author that wrote a poem, and he said, the hand that rocks the cradle rules the world.
Yeah.
Listen to me, how important it is. You don't know who it is that's been sitting under me. You don't know who it is that you've been giving suckle to.
Come on, preacher.
You need to be very careful because you may have somebody that is more important than anybody else. Lord, I mean, that can you just imagine?
Yeah.
Going all the way. He's about 12 years old, Brother Herman. Kind of got out of sight.
Yeah.
She's looking for it. She got other things to take care of.
She's a little older now.
She looks around and where's Jesus? He ain't here. They go looking for him. Where'd they find him? Right in the midst of all of it. He's down there talking to the elders. Glory be to God. She must have been doing something right. You say, but preacher, and let me tell you something. There was a little woman over there called Elizabeth. She also had conceived. When Mary got over there and started to tell Elizabeth what had happened, that baby went cool. Yeah, you think about it, Mom, that little baby was whoo. Brother Herman wasn't a normal jump.
No.
Said that baby leaped when you said that.
Yeah.
Yeah. John had met Jesus. So he was a forerunner of Brother Herman.
Yeah,
things beginning to line up. Somebody's important in the house today.
Yeah.
Anybody? Somebody's very important.
Sure, amen.
You might say, preacher, I'm not important. No, there's lots of people that didn't think Jesus and John was important. My, but down the road, Jesus could see him as they went. John kind of going one way, maybe meeting with Jesus once in a while as kids. But then Jesus down there in the temple, Mary gets a hold of him and said, me and your father, we've been looking for you for a while. Said, we're really concerned about you. Why did you left? He said, must not I be about my father's business?
Amen.
There's still some important things. And there was a little young lady standing right here. Never seen her before. Boy, she was getting the good out of what she was doing. Got to be about my father's business. Are you about your father's business this morning? Let me give you just a little bit more over here. Out of the book of Timothy, 2 Timothy. Oh, we're about the fifth verse. Apostle Paul talking to Timothy. I want to tell you about some things. Mother, and then I'm going to talk about motherhood just a little bit. He said, when I call to remembrance the unfeigned faith that is in thee, which dwelt first in thy grandmother, Lois, now listen to this. That same faith, Brother Herm, was passed down from grandmother to grandson. You say, well, what I do is not important. Honey, let me tell you something. Rocking that cradle, the hand that rocks the cradle, the voice that sings a song, the voice that reads the scripture, the actions that you do, the way you conduct your life, that is what's going to rule the world. You don't know if you've got the next president or the next king or whatever there is going to be in the future. You don't know who's in your house.
Amen.
And thy mother, Eunice, and I am persuaded that in thee also. You say, preacher, we got this new faith going on now. You're going to have to get somebody else to believe that. It ain't working. That goes with the dumbing down of the Christian faith. Yeah, we get down to the place to listen. My wife and I, we were talking, Brother Herm, about all that goes on.
Yeah.
We're looking at the clothing stores going out of business. Sears Roebuck going out. Penny's reducing and going out. She said, wonder what's going on? I said, well, you look at the churches. They don't dress like they used to. Don't dress like they used to. Used to they went to church and they dressed. Yeah, they dressed. I said, now we're getting away from that. There's not much honor in God's house.
Oh,
it's that's a hard one to swallow. It's okay. Once in a while I get a heart feel and I have to drink a couple of drinks. But the Lord take care of you this morning. Our society is dumbing down. Can you see that?
Yeah.
We're getting so far away. So far away from the good things. Yeah. They used to talk about it. It's not for sale. Brother Bruce, I believe you preached something like that one time. Mine's not for sale. But you look around, how much of it is at the flea market?
Come on, son.
Yeah, there's a flea market, Brother Bruce. We got a situation going on. Now, Timothy got his faith from his grandmother and from his mother being passed down from one to the other. Are you passing down anything to your grandchildren and to your children?
Come on.
Hey, listen, we got to do this. We got to get it into the communities. Our society, I thought about the Muslims. You know what the Muslims do? Every day they've got a time to pray. And everybody goes and everybody prays. I want you to understand that. And it doesn't make any difference who you are, how great you are. You've got prayer time and you go and you pray. They've got a time that they go back to the place where they were supposed to go all the time. Back to Mecca. Thank you, Herb. They go back to Mecca once a year. It don't make any difference if there's a bus a running or a plane a flying. They get on their shoes and they go back to Mecca.
Come on, son.
Now, I'm saying all that. I'm not giving them anything other than what they're doing. And I will show you this. I'll prove it to you. They are recognized by everybody because of their religion. It's not a salvation. It's a religion. Christ died for the sins of the world, and that is salvation. But religion is what you do daily. And they're recognized because of what they're doing all the time. All right to be a little bit religious. You can come to church. But when you get inside the church, it ain't going to church until you worship. You can't worship until the Holy Ghost comes. I don't care who you are, you can't worship until the Holy Spirit gets hold of your life and there's something there that goes bubbling up in your soul, mind overflowing. He said there'd be a river of water that would be flowing, overflowing in our lives. And I want you to understand today that it is still rich and full and true.
Yes.
This old book hasn't changed. It hasn't changed. But you look, if you want to be successful, carry it on your chest. Let everybody know who you are. comes time for prayer, don't you be ashamed of prayer.
Right.
When it comes time to get them little ones around in the evening and tell them about Jesus, don't you be ashamed of doing that. Turn the television off. Turn the computer off. Turn everything off. Go find you a calm, cool, still place. And take enough time to tell them about Jesus.
Yeah.
Tell them how he died on the cross. And how important it was for him to hang there. And after he talked to John and told him, said, John, behold your mother. Take care of her. He looked to the Father and he said, it's finished for the moment. One last thing he done, make sure mom took care of
him. Yeah.
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 Mom might not be very much anymore. Bible, who changed your diapers and who fed you? Who washed over you when you were sick and couldn't do anything? Yeah, hear me today. You think, well, I'm a mother. Yeah, you're a mother, but you're a mother because you got children. Amen. And you have a mother because you're here. You say, well, preacher, I didn't get to pick my mother. I didn't either. But my, listen, I wouldn't have had a better. I wouldn't have had a better. Remember them old frail hands, how she took care of everything. But listen, she told us about Jesus. She got in trouble one day, her and some problems going on. Her dad wasn't seeing eye to eye, said he needs to get saved. So children, the Bible says, she couldn't read the whole Bible, she said, the Bible says that if two or three would agree upon one thing, it shall be done. So children, I believe if we go yonder on the mountain and we pray, God will take care of dad. Listen to me. He did, but it was a different time. You today, celebrate your motherhood. Celebrate who you are. But don't ever forget who Jesus is.
Yeah.
Don't ever forget the shed blood. Don't ever drop your faith off. Don't ever be swept aside. But be who you are if it takes your life. Be who you are.
Amen.
Brother Boone.
You may come to your song. Little man gives an invitation. I believe God speaks to some soul. I just got to tell you, your mother is the only thing that you've got.
Amen.
Got to take care of her.
Amen.
Got to pet on her. I thought about Christ. We're the bride. We're her. And I'm in. I'm part of that. And she's beautiful. Her price is far above rubies. Talking about the church. It's your job to take care of it. Man, she's still beautiful. Let's stand, brother. Man, come back. Give invitation. There's lost people here. You might not be lost, but you need to pray. You're welcome to come and pray. The altar's open for everyone.
Will you come this morning? We'd love to pray with you. We'd love to help you find what God has in store for you. Will you come?
God bless you.
God bless you. Will you come?
Help me. Yes.
No matter what need you've got this morning, will you come?
Somebody.
The Lord's speaking to you in a still, small voice. There's a little fella called Samuel. He had a wonderful mother. She was barren for a long time. Couldn't come. She couldn't have a child. Finally, God give her a son. And just as quickly as he got weaned, she took him up to the house of God. And she led him to God. Let me tell you right now, God is calling you.
Amen.
Bless Sammy was in there on his bed one night. He come running back to the old priest and he said, did you call for me? No, he said, I didn't call for you.
Go back and lay down.
He said, go back and lay down. Come back again, Brother Herman. The old priest perceived what was going on.
Sure did.
He looked at him and he said, son, he said, you go back, and when you hear it again, he said, you answer to the Lord. Listen right now, that same voice that was calling Samuel is calling you right now. The eternal God of heaven has sent a voice to you saying, come. The broken pieces, I'll help you mend them. I want to tell you something. I've got a daughter, about 41 years old. She got so bound up in the demons of the drugs, she started serving the Lord, doing real good. But she forgot who he was. The old devil come back, grabbed hold of her again. The other day she said, Dad, I've been praying. I can't hear him. Just can't hear him. I don't know what your situation is today, but listen, she said, Dad, I want to commit suicide, but I know it's wrong. She said, Dad, what can I do? I said, you keep seeking him. He'll be there. When her heart got right with God, all of heaven come round about her. Would you like to see how the angels rejoice this morning?
Somebody, come on. So I believe God's talking to somebody.
Come right now.
Don't be backward. Don't be ashamed, please.
Come on.
Just come to him.
The best gift a mother could give to her children. The best gift a child could give to its mother.
Listen, every head bowed. As I look back, would you slip your hand up and say, preacher, just pray for us. I know. Would there be one? You've not made your call, Alexis, sure. You've not given your life to God. Would you slip up your hand and say, I need to be saved. Still, we still believe the old-fashioned way around here. We still believe it takes born-again experience. Would it be more? I can't imagine in a crowd like this, everybody knows Jesus. I hope so. Be great. Love you. Well, topped off a good service if somebody got saved. But what a message. That was a good message, wasn't it? This is my dad's brother, next to the youngest. And those boys. And I don't know how the girls were eating there, but I know she's sick from the youngest on the boys' side. But did you enjoy?
Amen.
Tony, he's a good preacher. His wife, Bonnie, she's a sweetheart. I want him to go back there and her take her with him. I want to love on you, slobber on you, kiss you, do whatever we do here, make you feel welcome once you come back. And we got a camp meeting, old fashioned tent meeting coming up. And we're looking for big services. People, you say how big people get saved. I don't care if the crowd's big. I just want people saved. That'll get big after a while. So let's pray that God will just do that. Got flyers back here. We'll get you one. Put it up on your refrigerator. Keep praying for this. Keep it by your bedside. Pray for us. I believe God's going to do some great things. We built the platform yesterday. Thank the Lord for the other three guys that helped in that. Awesome. Looks good. We're just going to have old-fashioned tent meeting, time, hallelujah, praise the Lord, shout. If you don't believe, shout, don't even show up, because it's going to be on. It'll say it's going to be on.
That guy right there, more excited than Chris did.
Praise Brother AJ, he's got a lot of decisions to make. Preaching is very important in his life right now. But everybody else don't feel that way. It's funny. People don't think that. We're struggling with things you guys can't even imagine. Trying to find God's way. And we'll pray for him. And tonight, we didn't cancel service tonight because I guess we're supposed to. But we didn't. Guess what? We're going to be here. You going to be here? You guys going to be here? All right. He's going to be preaching tonight. So we'll be prayer for him. And if my dad comes back, he can preach with us.
Amen.
I want my dad to come and be with us, teach Sunday school, and do things and help me. Guess God ain't big enough to move him. But we need to pray for God. Help him, move him. Hey, man, just kidding. Just joking. Some of you guys have to see. Come on, brother. Dismiss you tonight if you come back. Go pray. Take care of your mama today. If she ain't with you, go get you another mama.